It's not fair when mom and dad nag, nag, straight up strip, don't be rude. It's so not fair, cause the killer boy rats know school stinks, kids rule. So when they send you to your room, say a little tune. You sing na 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 na, na 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 na.
Tommy was Derek's bird. He was a pet that he bought from the store years ago. This is his head. He doesn't have hair. And he also has a back. Interesting. Obviously, birds have tails and backs. I'm saying this like you're stupid, and he has like a stain right there. I wonder why he has a stain. Tommy, do you wonder why you have a stain? You don't know why you have a stain. But anyways, Tommy was about to have the adventure of his life in the house today. But first, what should he do? Should he, the door. Is he gonna open it? He opens the door and he flies away. That was fast. He opens the door and flies away. And he turns on the lights. He turns on the lights. That's right. He turns on the lights. Good job, Tommy. And now, Tommy goes to the refrigerator to give himself a nice bird bath. But shouldn't he go to the sink for a bird bath? Other than the refrigerator? But maybe he should look outside first to see if there are any creepers out, or pedophiles, or whatever. Or else he'll kill them himself, without anybody wanting to kill him for him. You know, you shouldn't really take advantage of a little bird like Tommy. But anyways, no need to critique him. He's just being him. But back to what he was originally going to do. He was going to give himself a nice bird bath on a nice, beautiful day. But he should open the refrigerator first, shouldn't he? That's right. Well, really, he should go get some water from the sink, but I don't know how Tommy thinks. So, what should he use? What is he using to give himself a bird bath? Don't tell me he's gonna use some juice. I wonder what he's gonna do. Let's see. No. Oh no! No! Water? No, that's not water, it's milk. You gotta be kidding me, girl. Pepsi? Pepsi, oh no, 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 that bird is crazy. Are you serious, man? You really gonna take a bird bath with milk and Pepsi? You're the craziest freaking bird I've ever seen in my life. Wow. Wow. Oh, that's what she's gonna do. Okay. So, to continue with the story, Tommy is going to sit in a cereal bowl with milk and Pepsi mixed together, and he's going to chill for the day, I guess. So, Tommy is about to call his best friend Liguini on the phone. His broken iPhone. He broke several times in the street. And he's wanting to FaceTime his friend Liguini so they can have a nice conversation. Conversation.
Okay, I'll be right there. Okay, I'm just gonna talk to my friend for a minute. Oh my gosh. Jesus. Well, hey Tommy, how you doing, my man? How you doing, my man? You doing good? Okay, great. Okay, so, how's life going? How's that girl you've been talking to? You've been talking to that girl, that bird girl you've been talking to? Oh, come on, you still know how to talk to her? You're still simping? Oh, why are you such a simp, Tommy? Oh, it's beyond me. You don't have to be a simp. Okay, let me just give you advice. Let me give you some advice to talk to girls. Okay, first off, you have to be yourself. Go up to them. Be normal. Say something to them. You just can't expect them to talk to you. You have to talk to them first. Engage a conversation with them. You just can't let them just stare at you till you die. You have to just engage with them. Know their interests. You know that? That's the first step. We'll learn. What are you talking about? You don't know how to do it. Learn. Obviously, you're going to have to learn or go online. No, I'm the online for you. You have to listen to me. Okay, the second thing you need to do is be yourself. Even though I just said that already, but just be yourself. There really isn't nothing to it but to do it. You're already being yourself to me, right? So just be yourself to the girl. Be yourself to the girl. That's number B. And letter 13 is, you know, just be yourself. You know, just be yourself. Be a nice, humble guy to talk to. Be engaged in what she does. Buy her dinner. Talk to her on the phone. You know, buy her some gifts. Be yourself. And number 85, or letter 85, just take a shower. Take a shower. You don't want to stink for the girl. Girls don't like stinky people or animals like us. So you need to take a shower, wash wherever your crack is and your feathers are, and get to work. Talk to that girl you've been wanting to talk to, and don't be a simp. Girls don't like simps. Now go out there, be strong, be thankful, and pass the test today. You know, because I think you got to do a math test today. Or maybe it's, I don't know. What were you talking about again? Oh, yeah. Just talk to the girl and be yourself. Thank you. Go ahead. Oh, and did you know that George Washington died? It was so interesting. I cannot believe he died today. That was such... And why is nobody giving him a funeral right now? He just died. Right now, George Washington died. Like, he's our president. Like, why did he die? Like, he died just now. Like, why did he die just now? I had no idea he died. But anyways, go talk to the girl.
And remember, wash.
So Tommy took that advice to heart. Tommy was ready to talk to the girl or the bird of his dreams.
My name is October, and if you thought that was interesting...
My name is Maverick. Adding on to what he said, here comes something surreal.
Now let's all watch this.
This is Nero.
But what is it?
This is Nero. And this is not. This is Nero. And this is not.
Our seventh year of the Chili Cook-Off, and we do it once each semester. I like that students are able to express themselves.
This is Nero.
Can I get a awa awa?
And this is not. This is Nero. And this is not. And so is this one.
take a look at this ball. It's an unremarkable little bouncy ball. It's kind of fun, you know, I can bounce it into this mug. But take a look at what happens if instead of just bouncing it, I lick the ball first. Okay, now watch this.
Nero!
Popple, and welcome back to Hang with Popple with, well, Popple, because who else would it be? And today we're going to talk about trucks. I hate trucks. I cannot stand them. Why do I hate trucks? Well, one time I was walking down the street, minding my own business, mind you, and all of a sudden I looked both ways. You see? Let me demonstrate how I look. I look both ways. See? See? I look both ways. So, I was just looking both ways, and I walked down the street, and all of a sudden, this stupid truck comes. It's a UPS truck, of course. UPS trucks. And he ran me over, and the stupid package fell on my head. And that's why my hair looks like this. That is why my hair looked all crazy. You know what? I'm so mad talking about it right now that I need to go get my mango. Mango! 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 This has been Hanging with Popple. Bye. Mango!
And now, please be quiet for Pop Williams.
Nero!
So Tommy was ready Freddy to talk to that girl. Well, that bird that is a girl, that happens to be a girl, across the street. But first he has to do various things in order to talk to that girl. Because girls like certain things on a man. Or a bird man, which he is. A man bird man with a bird with pants. I don't know what the heck I'm saying. But Tommy is ready to talk to that girl. But first he needs to do the Didn't I just say that? Anyways, he's ready to go to the bathroom to go put on some nice things. Nice things. Get ready! Tommy is getting ready. Now, the first thing he has to do is put on some nice, stinky, smelly, pinky, pelly, kooky, panky, baka, booka, bika, lika, popo, dukata, cologne. All over his body. This might hurt a little, Tommy. Come on, Tommy. You know birds shouldn't stink. Tommy doesn't smell like old mice. He smells like old spice in a can. But that isn't old spice, that's Axe. Looks like Tommy's about to get the flower for the girl that he really likes. He should get the flower. What do you mean you're not gonna talk to girl? Oh, sorry. Okay, back to the episode. So, it looks like Tommy just being Tommy isn't going to speak to the girl he really, truly likes. Because he has to do certain things in order to talk to this girl, when he just wants to just be himself. He wants to be a little tiny, chirpy, chappy, stanky bird he is. And it looks like he really doesn't want to do all those things for that girl to impress her. Because he wants to do things that could impress him, like being himself. Which isn't really bad, but if you're going to talk to a girl to impress her, you have to do certain things, but just don't let her manipulate you, Tommy. That's the only thing that you can draw the line on. But it looks like Tommy doesn't want to talk to the girl. Well, this isn't turning out so good at all.
You're telling me you didn't talk to the girl because you didn't want to? What is wrong with you? Are you stupid? You're a freaking idiot! Dude, don't be a simp! I don't even think this is simp, I think you just don't care! Do you really not want to have a girlfriend? Do you really don't want to listen to things I say? Do you really not want to believe that George Washington died today as I'm speaking? You're a freaking idiot! Listen, you're my best friend, bro. But what you're doing is stupid. This right here you're doing right now is not cool. This is the dumbest thing you've ever did. Ever did. Like, you're really not going to talk to this girl because you think in your mind that, hey, you know what? I got to do certain things just for her to like me. Like, come on, man. Like, I just want to just be myself. And wait a minute. That's actually not bad. That's actually a very big move right there. I mean, yeah, surely you got to do certain things for a girl to like you, but it's not really manipulative things. But I mean, it's just like, you know, putting on some cologne, giving her a gift and saying how much you like her, whatever. And, you know, just taking chances. But you're just taking the other route to this. You're just like, you know what? Listen, I'm just not going to have nobody. I'm just going to be Tommy. I'm just going to be that bird. You know what I mean? You know what? I like you. I like you. You're my guy, man. I like you, Tommy. You're the bro. You're the bro. I take back everything I said. I'm sorry, man. Do your thing, man. Do your thing. You do you. Okay, you do you. And, I gotta go. I gotta, figure out, some things in my life. I don't know what the heck I'm doing right now. I think I gotta pee. See ya. I gotta go pee.
Actually, no, I don't have to pee. But, okay. Okay, I'm glad you did not do that. I'm glad you did not go over there and talk to that girl. And I hope we can be friends after this, Tommy. I hope we can be friends. But I was sort of speaking to her before you. Please don't get mad at me for this, but we were kind of doing a thing, you know, we were on a date and whatever, and, you know, we really like each other, and, okay, let me just let the cat out the bag. We were dating. She really likes me, and she has said a lot of mean, nasty things about you. I told her to stop. I said, listen, that's my bro, man. I really like Tommy. He's my guy. He's my bro. But look, she wouldn't stop. She said a lot of mean, nasty things about you. She said, first off, you stink. She said that every time you cross the street when you fly, she said you stunk. Like, she thinks you smell so bad. The second thing she said about you, she says, like, she just really doesn't like you. Like, she just thinks you're not attractive at all. She thinks that, like, first off, like, you don't even talk. Like, you just chirp. I know you can speak, but, like, you barely do. All you do is just chirp. That's your thing. You just like to chirp. And she really doesn't like that. She likes, you know, big boys and bad boys who can, like, talk and whatever. And, yeah, she likes bad boys. And I'm not a bad boy, but still, like, you know, she's my girl. And, you know, Sadie loves me. Sadie loves me, okay? Sadie doesn't like you. Sadie loves me, okay? And she will never like you. She just thinks you're ugly as heck. And she even thinks that you just stink. And she just really thinks you're not the one for her right now. And, you know, I'm sorry to tell you that, but she just doesn't like you. I'll see you later. I really gotta go pee now. Bye.
I cut universe. My name is Aika, and this is my song. Aika's universe.
Hey kiddos, I'm Acup, and this is my universe. Now there's some people who talk about us bears the wrong way and don't get a good idea. Well, never fear, Acup is here to fix that strategy. Here is my bear facts done in the way so people can understand it well. Trust me, this will make you understand us well. Number 1. Bears protect. This is mostly for us to take care of ourselves so no one won't harm us. It's also for the parent bears to look after their bear cubs. When it comes to that, we are super serious. Number 2. Bears are wise. We have better knowledge for many things. We can even read a Shakespeare book better than a human can. Way better. Number 3. We eat fish. Every bear in the world loves to eat a good fish. Especially if they're rotten, and we go crazy over salmon. I can feel for some right now. Number 4. Bears can be vicious animals. We're mainly like this for people we don't know, so we viciously attack them because we feel like it. We can't calm down. Well, except for me, of course. Number 5. Bears stink really bad. Most of us smell like if you're walking down the street and you end up smelling something gruesome, you look down and it's a big steamy pile of I'm not like that though, just my ancestors. Number 6. Bears love water. We love to keep our mouths nice and fresh, and we don't really mess around too much with high-functioning fat sodas. Number 7. Bad breath. Yes, stanky, nasty, danky, banky, fanky, everything but Kevin Spacey, bad breath. This is probably due to most of us not brushing our teeth at all. And it's also for how much fish we eat.
Mainly the catfish.
Number 8. We're loyal. You know, if you finally find the right girl or boy you date, and they're actually loyal people in your lives? That's what us bears are. Number 9. We like searching for things. No, seriously. A lot of things. We just search for like any single thing you can think of. Mostly wood, sticks, grass, shoes, the list goes on. And then there's number 10. We have strong nails. If you know us bears well, we will scratch you to a point where blood comes boiling down your eyes and face. We're strong, that's what. And that's the facts people should know about us bears. There's another fact, but it's a secret no one should know about. I don't do that certain thing, but other bears do. Well, I'll see you next time on iCup's Universe. May the bear be with you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this about Tommy, because it's a day-to-day life thing that Tommy does every day when he's in here. And I hope Tommy himself actually enjoyed it, didn't you? He does enjoy it. I knew he would enjoy it. I know he enjoys doing that. I'll see you guys later. And peace out.
So, what can you do with sauce?
It's a slam dunk.
So basically, what can you do?